This is a D5 fridge, and this compressor is Seco, made in Brazil, and there's a blockage in the system, but we're lucky it's not completely blocked. There's still a bit of circulation, but we've got to clear the blockage. Now what I did was I removed the suction from the compressor and the capillary here, and we weld a valve on each side like that. Now what I did was I used a bottle of, this is 404 gas, which is, the pressure is slightly higher than the 134A. So we attach the charge line and we blow it up the capillary and we blow it here. So we move the dirt around inside until we get to a point where the dirt can be blown out. So by just adding a bit of 404 here, it does come through the capillary now, but it's still not completely clear. Now, it's nice to know if you find out what caused the blockage. Now, on this particular compressor, the Seacom, the copper wires inside the winding has a coating on it, and this coating dissolves when the compressors run very hot, and this dissolved coating goes into the system and it will block the capillary. Now, we find when it blocks like that, it's normally the end of the capillary closest to the inside that blocks. So what we do is we actually put some thinners, normal thinners, in the system, which actually dissolves it. But you don't want thinners in the compressor, it harms it. So what I do is this charge line here, I connect to a vacuum pump, and I have a little container with thinners here, and we suck a vacuum, and that will suck a little bit of thinners up the capillary tube, and then straight away blow it out with the 404 gas. Okay, we've connected the charge line onto our vacuum pump, and this is the thinners. So we just poured a little bit of thinners into a container. Put the end of this, which is the valve to your capillary, in the thinners, and we switch the vacuum pump on. Now it will suck a vacuum up the suction in the system, which will allow a little bit of thinners to be sucked into the system. Now you don't want to suck too much in. If the thinners finds its way back through into the vacuum pump, it can damage it. So we do this for about 30 seconds. A little bit of the thinners will go into the system. Switch the vacuum pump off. And then I normally put this up to see what comes out of the system. So straight away from a vacuum, we go onto the 404 gas. We open it. And there it's blowing the thinners out. And hopefully some of the dirt as well. And you can hear it blowing, and it comes out with the dirt and the thinners mixed, and it's dissolving the resin and the dirt. Okay. Now we can see what came out of the system. It's mostly thinners, but there is a lot of dirt in the thinners as well. What the thinners does is it dissolves the resin inside the capillary, but it moves the dirt around, and once the thinners dries, this resin is even harder than before. So you want to blow it out as quickly as possible, and we use the 404 until we come to the point where it blows evenly. Then I will put some thinners on this side. I will apply thinners in here, and we'll probably blow about 50 mils of thinners through the system with the 404 until this comes out clean. And we're sure we've got all the resin out of the system, and then the thinners that's left behind I will clean with the refrigerant flushing system. There's quite a few on the market, but I don't use the flushing system to clean the dirt. I use it to remove the thinners once we've cleared the blockage. Thanks.